Hi everyone, today in this video let us discuss about glycolic acid cream. When you have dark skin spots or acne, acne scars, even wrinkles on the skin, for all these conditions you may be given with glycolic acid cream, which is one of the exfoliating agent. This glycolic acid is having few of the advantages. It is one of the water soluble acidic compound. Because of water solubility, when this glycolic acid is applied on the skin, it mainly produces exfoliation of the skin. That means these molecules can remove the surface cells on the skin, which removes the dead skin cells. That's why glycolic acid is an exfoliating agent. But because of water solubility, many of the acidic compounds cannot enter into the deeper layers of the skin. This limitation is not observed with glycolic acid. Glycolic acid is the small acidic compound with low molecular weight. Because of this low molecular weight and small size, glycolic acid can enter into the deeper layers of the skin where it can reduce the pigmentation. Thereby, it can reduce the dark spots on the skin. In this way, glycolic acid acts as a popular exfoliating agent along with reducing the skin darkness. Then what is this glycolic acid? Glycolic acid is one of the alpha hydroxy acid, commonly known as AHA. These alpha hydroxy acids are coming from the different types of natural sources and they have general structure like this. And here you can observe carboxylic acid, which results in their acidic property. Now to this carboxylic acid, at alpha carbon, a hydroxyl group is attached. That's why they are called alpha hydroxy acids. We have different types of alpha hydroxy acids, including glycolic acid, lactic acid, citric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid. In this way, we have so many types of alpha hydroxy acids. All these components are derived from the natural sources. For instance, glycolic acid is derived from the sugar cane, and lactic acid is highly available in the dairy products as well as fermented vegetables. Citric acid is obtained from the citrus fruits. Malic acid is obtained from the apples. Tartaric acid is present in the grapes. In this way, all these alpha hydroxy acids are derived from the natural sources. All these acidic components can produce exfoliating of the skin, and they can also reduce the darkening of the skin. But among them, glycolic acid is one of the widely used alpha hydroxy acid. If we see the structure, this is the simple structure of glycolic acid. Here we can clearly observe at the alpha carbon, a simple hydrogen is attached. So glycolic acid is the small molecule among the alpha hydroxy acids. This glycolic acid structure can be further extended to produce other alpha hydroxy acids. For instance, this is a structure. This is nothing but lactic acid. In the lactic acid, we can observe a methyl group is attached at alpha position. And this is the structure of malic acid, where we can observe an extra carboxylic acid group. So malic acid is a diacid. Similarly, this is the structure of tartaric acid, where it is having an extra hydroxyl group at beta position. Finally, this is the structure of citric acid. In this structure, we can observe this is the carboxylic acid and this is another carboxylic acid directly attached to alpha carbon. So citric acid is a triacidic compound. All these are alpha hydroxy acids, but we can clearly observe that glycolic acid is a simple alpha hydroxy acid, which is widely used as exfoliating agent. So today in this video, we are going to see what are the clinical use of this agent, how this glycolic acid acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, and how it should be used. All these points we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see what are the uses of this glycolic acid. Glycolic acid is mainly used for the conditions like aging of the skin, where along with aging, we can observe some wrinkles on the skin as well as darkening of the skin. This glycolic acid can act as an exfoliating agent, so it can remove the dead cells on the skin. So age-related dead cells which are accumulated on the surface layers of the skin can be removed by glycolic acid. Similarly, it can reduce the wrinkles, which can produce some de-aging of the skin structure. And even it restores the skin from any sun damage. Any dark spots can be removed by use of glycolic acid. Similarly, it can also be used for the conditions like acne, where glycolic acid can reduce the acne eruptions. It can unclog pores on the skin. In the acne, most of the skin pores are clogged, which further increases dead cell accumulation. So with use of glycolic acid, the pores are opened because of its exfoliating action. So it can unclog the pores on the skin, which reduce the acne development. Similarly, it removes blackheads. All this can cure the acne, but for the treatment of acne, glycolic acid should be used for at least few weeks in order to show its beneficial effects. Third one, it can be used for the treatment of dark skin patches. We have already discussed that glycolic acid is a small alpha hydroxy acid, so it can penetrate deeply into the skin, where it can enter into the dermal cells, which accumulated with pigmentation. So it removes the melanin buildup in the deeper layers of the skin, which reduce the darkness of the skin. Even glycolic acid can improve the skin brightening. All this can reduce the dark patches on the skin. Finally, glycolic acid can also be used for treatment of acne scars. These are the small lines on the skin because of development of acne. Now, glycolic acid can reduce the size of acne pores, which reduce the lining, and even it removes the surface lines. All this can reduce any scars produced after the acne. So these are the various use of glycolic acid. Now let us see how glycolic acid acts. Being an alpha hydroxy acid, it can act in different ways. The first one, it can produce exfoliation of the skin. So this is the main action of glycolic acid. It reduces the dead cells on the skin, and it also reduces the melanin pigmentation, so it can change the skin tone, and even it can increase the skin renewal, so new cells are more rapidly formed on the skin with use of glycolic acid. Even glycolic acid can promote the blood flow to the skin cells, which further increase the skin renewal. So with use of glycolic acid, dead cells are removed and new cells are formed and pigmentation is reduced, which restore the skin conditions. This is the normal skin. This normal skin can be accumulated with dead cells by exposure with many of the factors. By impact of pollution or direct contact with sun rays, particularly UV radiation, or due to any aging of the skin, any of these factors can produce some modification of skin structure, leading to the development of dead skin cells. Now, glycolic acid is an exfoliating agent. It can act on the dead skin cells, where it can produce skin eruptions and skin exfoliation. Thereby, it can remove the dead skin cells, as well as it accelerates new cell formation. This reduces aging effects as well as darkening of the skin. Now let us see the precautions of glycolic acid. One of the important precautions of glycolic acid is with its concentration. When this glycolic acid is used at higher concentrations, greater than 10%, it can increase the UV sensitivity. So in such people, with use of glycolic acid, skin irritation and skin burning can be observed. But this UV sensitivity can be reduced with stopping of glycolic acid. So it is a temporary condition where sensitivity is going to be developed towards UV radiation with higher concentration of glycolic acid. That's why it is always recommended to use lower concentration of glycolic acid in order to avoid any skin irritation. Another important precaution is that this glycolic acid acts as an exfoliating agent, so it can reduce the skin thickness. So if you are using the glycolic acid at higher concentrations for longer days, the skin thickness may be slightly reduced, which may increase the risk of sunburn when these people are exposed to sunlight. That's why with long-term use of glycolic acids, you should avoid direct exposure with sunlight in order to prevent any sunburn and skin irritation. Now let us see the side effects of glycolic acid. Normally, glycolic acid is well tolerated. But when it is used at concentrations greater than 10%, or when the pH of the cream is greater than 3.5, in such conditions, glycolic acid can produce few of the side effects like skin burning and skin irritation. Particularly at higher pH, it can produce some skin irritation. So generally, glycolic acid at an optimal pH to avoid skin irritation. But this cream is available at lower strengths as well as higher strengths. When you are going to use at higher strengths, the side effects like skin burning and skin irritation are more observed. How it is given? Glycolic acid is available as a cream at different strengths like 6%, 10%, 12%, and even up to 15%. But it is always recommended that this cream should be used at a concentration less than 10%, where it have less skin irritation and skin burning. For instance, glycolic acid is used at 6% cream, which is sufficient for exfoliation as well as removal of dark spots on the skin. So when it is used at lower concentrations, this cream can be used once daily. But when it is used at higher concentrations, about 10%, this cream should be used twice a week in order to minimize its side effects. So that's all about this cream, glycolic acid, which is one of the popular exfoliating agent that can reduce dark spots on the skin as well as removes the wrinkles. It can produce de-aging of skin structure, even it can remove acne scars. All these are the clinical use of glycolic acid, which is the small molecule with more water solubility, which can act on the surface of the skin as well as it can also act into the deeper layers of the skin. This cream is recommended to be used at lower concentrations less than 10%, where it produces very mild side effects. So that's all about this alpha hydroxy acid. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.